like that? Like that. It's a lot of money. Why are you mad like that? Like that. Ooh, ooh. I'm in my new bag, my bag. You ain't get too bad, my bag. Yeah. First of the month, I'ma run it back. Ay. Same day, why I'ma run it back? Yeah. Friday, payday, run it back. Ay. Run it back, run it back, run it back. Ooh. 48 yards, I run it back. Ay. I cop a car, I run it back. Yeah. Go your then run it back. Run it back, run it back, run it back. Hello? That's the check calling. Talk it. Let me click over real quick to let my check talk it. Talk it, talk it. Ooh, Pac-Man, that's the way my neck talking. Right? I ain't never coming back the way the stress.
You don't make no clap back when you backpack, my bad, but I'm past that. But an ass back, that's cash. When the money fall, I'ma slap that. Clap when the money go, you don't slap. That's facts. If the money low, I'ma grab. Brown man, when it come back, I'ma give back my bad. When the check hit, the direct hit, I'm glad. When the check missed, the direct hit, I'm sad. Like,
who's that knocking at my window?
My window.
They say that it's the money, I'm like tenfold.
Over and out.
That's gonna make you fuck like a limbo. She say she not a. She an. Ay. Why you do that like that?
Like that?
It's a lot of money. Why are you mad like that?
Like that?
Ooh, ooh, I'm in my new bag, my bag.
You ain't get
too bad, my bag.
Yeah.
First of the month, I'ma run it back.
Ay.
Same day, why I'ma run it back?
Yeah.
Friday, payday, run it back.
Ay.
Run it back, run it back, run it back.
Ooh. 48 yards, I run it back.
Ay.
I cop a car, I run it back.
Yeah.
Go your then run it back.
Run it back, run it back, run it back.
There ain't no time, is it? Playing skills, you did.
Playing
skills. Ice on the wrist, car on the wrist, holding the wrist, watch how I flip, watch how I whip, I'm in the whip, holding the wrist, I never switch, ice on the wrist, car on the wrist, holding the wrist, watch how I flip, watch how I whip, I'm in the whip. All in the rest, I never switch. Ice in the rest, I get the money, but I never switch. They say you switch, you won't do it. You know they came from the bottom, and now we is lit. You was lit, I gotta get it, I gotta get it. You hatin' cause I still the rest. Why bitch, you wanna be famous, They LA, they made us, You know I'm pricey in Vegas, This for the that hate us, I make a lot of new money, When the not save us, You be liking my flavor, I think it's cause I still the rest.
Since I blew, they all on my. Hey, back then, they know I exist. Don't touch my cup, you know how I sip. Hey, got your long. Thought I made her when I showed out my whip. Hey, spent my 10 on my 50. X slick, then hit with the. Back then, you out the zip. Blow out his back, then dip. Got a whole hole for the all on the ship. All these four things pull out the vip. Suck, turn up, baby, pour out the milk. So you know how I drip. Crush.
Yeah. Hey. Yeah. Let's go.
about to make a play. Move the chains, tell them get about the way. Move the chains, I'm about to win the game. Move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains. I score up in the end zone, do my dance all on a hater. A mover and a shaker, you an novice, I'm a player. I'm from DC, but I'm running through and sacking like a raider. Two chains on my neck, one for now and one for later. And we don't play fair, baby, we play for keeps. You can pass me up, this is not a bye week. I'm looking for a trophy competition, looking steep. Yeah, I'm training, I've been focused, I've been bombing from the deep. I'm like, move the chains, I'm about to make a play. Championships, all my records go hard, this a champion hit, yeah. I've been working for this moment like I've been in the gym, jumping all over hurdles, I'm evading the pit, yeah. Head to head with anybody, take them, I can shake them, yeah. I invite them to the fire, then I bake them, I'ma break them, hey. I'm a Hall of Fame legend, they should go and hang my jersey, yeah. Made to put in work, I don't think they really heard me like, yeah. Move the chains, I'm about to make a play, move the chains, tell them get about the way, move the chains, I'm about to win the game, move the chains, baby, tell them move the chains, yeah. Ain't no stopping me, ain't no topping me, I am up, number one seed. Nobody popping up. Got a squad of gorillas from the jungle suited up. You kicking off against me, hope you ready, get it up. I be booted up, popping out a sprinter or a truck. Whole team chasing bags while they chasing us. Call an audible, I read the game, I think it's...
All right, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion Denver Broncos taking on the NFC champions, the Detroit Lions. I'm Brandon Gunn. To my left is my good friend Charles Davis, and what a thrill to be here for the biggest one of them all, the Super Bowl. And it seems to get bigger every year. The lights get brighter, the cameras more numerous. I don't know, there's just so much that goes into this game. It's an honor to be here, isn't it?
It is an honor, and I can't wait to share this game with you. This is going to be a whole lot of fun. You're my partner, my best friend. I can't imagine being anywhere else but right here with you. And just think about it this way. You mentioned the magnitude. This is no longer just a game for America or even North America. This is worldwide. People watching from just about every country in the world. This is impressive.
The biggest stage, the biggest game, and just about ready to roll. They're going to get 9 here on first down as he gets this one up to the 34-yard line. So that flag will cost him 15.
And it doesn't matter anymore how you get the face mask. Any part of it, that's going to be 15 yards.
So the face mask, quite a blessing there, as they'll start out of harm's way with a first and 10. On first and 10, here's Locke. And his first look is incomplete. He was looking to get it to Philip Lindsay there. That'll bring up second down.
Well, touch and time are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. On second down, a run with Lindsay. He's got a first down and then some inside the 40. A big play on the ground there. It goes for 36 yards.
Sometimes those lines that are drawn on a grease board or in a playbook, they come to life out on the field, don't they? And we just saw that in that outside handoff to the right.
That right tackle, he gets excited for that call, doesn't he?
He does, because he just wants to dominate his guy and say, listen, I was the point of attack. I took care of business. That's why you're able to get downfield and add all those yards to your total.
Yeah, really nice gain there. Into the red zone, it's Locke. He'll find Lindsay here. And the nimble footwork gets him just inside the 10 to the 9, but no further. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll make it a second down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit, but get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make him make some.
And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown with the first touchdown of this Super Bowl, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter.
Looking sharp on that first drive. These guys, of course, coming off back-to-back victories, and you see that kind of advancing into this game, don't you?
You certainly do, and when you have a team that doesn't get too full of itself, even though they've won two games in a row, you get the end result that we saw there, that nice opening drive, because they're sharp, they're focused, and they're locked into everything that they're doing.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This will be fielded at the six. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Stafford and the Lions now have it first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Level right.
Now it's the former Bronco. This is C.J. Anderson. He was brought down there by Will Parks.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Second and five now. Stafford. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. A shotgun snap for Stafford. And that will be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. That hurts. If it was running into the kicker, wouldn't be a first down. Roughing, it is a first.
And just think about the differences between the two. Running into the kicker almost feels inadvertent, just a small tap, so to speak. But when you rough him, usually bodies are hitting the ground and flying all different places. And the difference is 5 yards or 15. And in this case, that's a big play.
And he's got it across midfield and into Denver territory.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
53, ready, 59, 51, easy, easy.
From just shy of midfield, Stafford, a dump off to Anderson. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
First down. Here's the run with Anderson. He's got the first down here inside the 30 and all the way down to the 17-yard line. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get left.
And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. It's picked up by the Broncos.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble. From what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet they are humans out there running around. And we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Locke and the Broncos going to come up first and 10 at their own 18. Following the fumble recovery, it's Locke rolling to his left. Open man, that's Noah Fant, the tight end. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. Just like that, a pickup of 20 on their first play from scrimmage. From all the way up at the 38 now after a good start to the drive.
Come on, come on. You gotta be ready.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Man open. He's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. The Bronco first down there, 12 yards on the play.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On first and 10, it's Lindsey. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Go!
From midfield, here's Locke. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
They face a third and four after that last completion gets him six. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here.
Slap, slap, slap.
From the gun on third down, Locke. Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Coleman. And they have the football and will take over at the 24-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Stafford dumping it off for Johnson. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. 11 yards there and a Lion first down.
Nice little nifty play for him there. That's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody covered. Oh, he just snuck out there and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards, but also like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off.
On second down, Anderson. And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
Oh, and the hard count might have got him. This might be a first down. A little eager there coming in from his outside linebacker position.
You think the hard count got him there?
Yes.
Maybe that extra hut, that extra emphasis on it, got him to jump, and they picked up 5 yards.
Here's a first and 10 now after they successfully drew him offside. From the gun, here's Stafford. That'll be taken in by Anderson. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. From the gun, it's a give to Anderson. And he's got this down to the 35. 11 yards there and a Lion first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
On first and 10, Stafford. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. Again, Stafford. He'll get this one to Galladay. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
Snap! Blue 60!
Rip left, rip left. Watch tight end. Three down.
Snap!
They'll run, Anderson. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. A 6-yard touchdown run as they are now on the board here in the first half. And there you go. Nothing really too complex. Block, keep your assignments, let them run it in. They did it.
Fundamental football. Good blocking beats good tackling on that play. End result, touchdown.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and 5. They look to throw. It's locked. Screen pass to Lindsey. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down. So negative yardage, a loss of 3 on second down, and that leads to a tough third down call.
Yeah.
Throwing his lock on third down. And Jeffrey's got it. A good pickup there, a 22.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence, when in doubt, find your veterans.
He used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s, you're still playing receiver, but you're around that long at that position, you're doing something right.
Just remember this. When he was young, he thought the crafty veteran was simply a guy who couldn't run anymore. Now he understands a little bit better.
Brock now, after the pick on the last drive, 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's first and 10. Now it's Lindsey. Telvin Smith that time there to make the play.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Jeff,
3, 218, chop.
On second and 7, block. Pressure, and he's going to be taken down. They sack him back right around the 44. Romeo Okwara. He's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. On third and long, it's Locke. And that is incomplete. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
On fourth down, on is Colby Wadman now to punt. This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And out of bounds, sailed over, looked like right near the pylon. This one's going to be perfect. Directional kicking at its finest right down at the 1 yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They scored a touchdown the last time they had the football, but things are going to be a little bit more difficult this time.
Oh, certainly, because where they're starting, the goal isn't even thinking about a touchdown at this point. They're thinking about field position. A couple of first downs in order to give some room for their punter and maybe flip the field position for their defense.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. They run, Anderson. And just not much to be had there, 1 yard out to the 10.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. They'll run it. Here's Anderson. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. That good for 19 and a first down.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
The throw over the middle, taken in. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL.
Move, move, kill, kill, kill.
10th carry now for Anderson. Looking for a seam but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage and that's it. They'll say no gain on the play there and now it'll be third down.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
He's crazy. 9! Easy, easy!
From the gun on third down, Stafford. And he'll find Galladay. That's complete. And this is going to be another first down as he'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 44-yard line. He's such a good route runner, shows it there on third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
On first down, Stafford here. And this will be incomplete.
physical play on the football there, and it's second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. It actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. To throw again, Stafford. He gets this one to Johnson. Johnson with a burst, a first down or more. And this is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 22-yard line.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
On first down, Anderson. And they'll get him down right about the 20. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Now it's Stafford. Open man, he's got him, the tight end Hockenson. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Stafford going to come up first and 10, and he's 5 for 6 now throwing the ball on this drive. Out of the gun, Stafford. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him, made it very tough for him to get the ball.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
So the penalty certainly helps them out as they come up on second and 5. Following the penalty, Anderson. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. And the Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number 1. They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. 65. Stafford on third down. And these guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. And we will likely not see another play here as they take the knee and head into the intermission all tied.
So we've reached halftime here in Super Bowl 55 as we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Both teams ready after the halftime spectacle, and we are back underway in Super Bowl 55. This is taken at the three. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up.
Brings up second and two at the 37-yard line.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple.
Big 20.
They run it again with Anderson. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
I saw Von Miller in college at Texas A&M. And all I kept hearing about was his speed off the edge to the quarterback. But what impressed me, his balance and his ability to take on blocks and be a force in the run game, as we just saw there.
From the gun on third down. Stanford, open man is Taylor, he's got it. His first catch of this Super Bowl, and it'll be good for a first down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Stanford now, 11 of 17 passing thus far. He's got his guys a first and 10. Now a run with Anderson, and he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is a well big man.
White. Hey. You got
on second and 11 now. Stanford, nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Derek Wolfe, it'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him.
We are seeing two really confident defenses imposing their will on these offenses in this game.
Yeah, absolutely, going toe for toe. Just curious if one of these offenses can wake up a little bit.
Is there any way they can find something that can pop, something big to knock them back on their heels?
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. So a stop here defensively to start this third quarter. Just what's needed in a tie ball game.
Yeah, good chance to build back some momentum on the defensive side of the ball. In fact, what they've done is give their offense a nice push in the back as they get ready to take the field.
Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie. Here's a second and 5 now from the 25.
Hey, wahoo!
Locked to throw on second down. This one complete to the running back, Lindsey. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
That was a pretty favorable situation there. What would you call that, second and manageable? Smart play, too. Didn't force it downfield when he didn't have it. Just checked it down, let him get the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
So first and 10 now from the 30.
They'll run on first down. Lindsey,
no gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10.
57 to Mike. 57 to Mike. I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you.
Hey, Alpha.
57 to Mike. Watch 57.
Man, I got you. I got you. I got you.
Look at me. Zipper.
On second down, here's Locke. And this is going to be incomplete.
Timing's crucial in any route thrown, but when you throw an out, so many things are going through the mind of the receiver. Catching the ball, timing it up with the quarterback. Are my feet going to get down inbounds? On that play, all those things going through his head might have caused him to drop it.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
57, come on. It's out of time. It's out of time, guys. It's out of time. 57, come on.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And he'll hit Jeffrey, complete. His second catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
The tackle made there by Jared Davis.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
The last run got three. Now here's second and 7. Now Locke throwing on second down. Steps away to his left. It's brought in by Jeffrey. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions' 38-yard line.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 38. Lock now on first down. And it's complete to Jeffrey. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Give him 32 on the play.
Goal at the 6-yard line. Ready? AQ Gator. Protein spill.
Let's go. 49. Check 49. Check 49.
Ready?
Now Locke. And that is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Noah Fant there to make the grab. And the Broncos have taken the lead. He was on point throwing the ball right there. He had the big play to get him down close, and then he delivers a touchdown pass on first and goal.
And you mentioned the big play that got him down close. I think that big play left him reeling a little bit. They didn't recover from it. And you know they always talk about having to have a short memory on defense after a big play against you? Looks like their memory was a little too long there.
Extra point from McManus is good. And that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
Let's go!
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They run with Anderson. He's been the bell cow tonight. A 6-yard pickup on the ground that time, and that'll make it 3rd and 4 coming up.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
The Broncos going dime. Two extra defensive backs for third down.
Playing pass all the way.
A give to Anderson here out of the gun. And he will not get there as they stop him short right around the 34-yard line. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a 4th down.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on 4th down. Lions go for it on 4th. It's Stafford. He's got his man, T.J. Hockenson. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 4th down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, 1st and 10. Anderson. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, 2nd down.
His carries tonight, they're getting up there, so maybe one of those every now and then is understandable.
I would agree with that. Understandable every now and then. Sometimes you come back and you fake it to him and go play action. But other times you say, okay, they got him on that one. We'll come back to him in another carry.
Looking to throw on 2nd down. Stafford buying time to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Pressure, and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Von Miller in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to 4th down. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And they'll cut the lead back down to 4 now at 14-10.
So an interesting call there to take the 3. I mean, I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, 4th quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet.
A good run, got 7 on 1st. Here's 2nd and 3.
Go! 6-6, pull it high.
Block now to throw. He's got his big tight end, Fant. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain there of 21 yards. Block now. Perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's 1st and 10. They'll throw out wide, complete to Sanders. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags.
Let's go. Let's do it.
So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they march off another 15 against your squad.
After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's 1st and 10.
Watch the safety creep.
Recon, 132 fighter.
On the counter, Lindsey. That's a gain of 4 here in the 4th quarter, with them leading by 4 on the scoreboard.
I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Philip Lindsay, 26 yards. And the Broncos push further out in front. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. McManus's point after is good, and that makes it a 21-10 game. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. Under 4 to go now as they come up on 2nd down.
Let's go, tackle. Let's go. We got this. We got this.
Throwing again. Stafford. He finds Taylor. Complete. His 2nd catch of the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a 1st down. Stafford now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's 1st and 10. Now this throw caught left side and able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. Now Anderson. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 1st down Detroit, 16 yards on the pickup. Now a 1st down throw, Stafford. He'll find Taylor, that's complete. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
It's a gain of 7 Brings up second and three.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Now Stafford. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Jermaine Kearns there to make the grab as his guys are back within a single score. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
There's certainly some importance to this one now. After the touchdown, they could get this down to a field goal with a two-point conversion.
Hey, Charlie!
From the gun, here's Stafford. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play, focus, focus, focus. Watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And he'll get this from the 25 to the 30 for a pickup of five. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. They'll run it down. To protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. And this defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. The Broncos on third down. They've hit two for four thus far. This is third and eight. Throwing his lock on third down. And that's complete to Sanders. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. It'll be a gain of eight, but it'll also lead to a fourth down. As Super Bowl 55 down to the final 2 minutes.
Got it.
So it's Bronco football as we get you reset here. They're looking at a fourth down now as they try to hold on to this lead for dear life. Going to take it all the way down and just take the delay. That's going to set him back 5 yards. The Broncos send out their punter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he gets it away, and it's a laser headed for the sidelines. This one will sail out of bounds. It'll depend on the spot here. And the side judge says that went out at the 7-yard line.
So well done there. And these punters, they get more specialized and better each and every year, don't they?
They sure do. And now it's really not the American punters. It's the Australian punters with their kicking academies and that flat drop and just kind of kicking.
And Stafford's going to be taken down. That's a safety. And that disastrous play partner is ultimately going to seal their fate in this one, isn't it?
It certainly is, because they give up the 2 points, but that's not really what did it. It's happened to give up the football. And because they gave up the football, guess what? The other team now can take the ball and close this game out.
And remember, following the safety, you give the football up as well, and they free kick it from the 20 now. So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Good starting position for the Broncos here as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. Now a carry for Lindsey. Damon Harrison, the one on the stop. And the Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. And they take a knee. So here we go, Charles, third down. Any chance you're throwing?
I don't think so. I think you got to keep the clock rolling here.
Now the Broncos going to use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
Here we go! 60 or. Ready?
And indeed they will keep it on the ground. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. That'll back them up 2 yards and also bring up fourth. It's fourth down. The Broncos send out their punter now as he's on to kick it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, You've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense and make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's not just the ball being tipped in the air and people in the end zone in a cluster. It's that guy that's short in the end zone who comes up and ends up making the play because he goes unguarded. So there's a lot to think about if you're playing defense in this situation.
We'll see if they can cover all their bases.
Now Stafford. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end.
And he'll be out right at the 35.
15 yards for the Lions there and a first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly.
And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. And the Lombardi Trophy goes west. And it goes to the Denver Broncos, your Super Bowl champs. And their remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name, Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them, a fantastic season.
Hear just how everybody wants to end the year, holding the Lombardi Trophy. What a season for them. What a ride it's been for us as well here in the booth. For Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. Thanks for watching, everybody. We will see you next season right here on EA Sports.